Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Anna, aka NeurogalMD. I'm a neurologist who loves making videos about brain-related topics. I also really enjoy making music reaction videos because I think there's a lot to learn from music. We can learn a lot about ourselves through songs, and we can process and deal with the challenges of life through music. Today, I'm going to be reacting to Chalk Outlines by Ren and Chinchilla. I've gotten a lot of requests to do this. I'm super excited. Let's get started. Oh, and I apologize. I'm in a hotel room. I totally forgot my fancy microphone, so I hope you guys don't mind. Lots of flickering lights in his songs. I sense some symbolism here.
Still here in this bed that I crawled in. I hope that I'm someone else in the morning. So take this one, wash it down, and you'll be fine. Walk around in the floating chalk outline. So it goes, let it be. In the gallows, balanced on my toes so I can breathe. But little by little, bit by bit, I push it back.
About the side effects they're experiencing from psychiatric medications. They feel like chalk outlines. They don't feel like themselves. They just feel like outlines of human beings. For some people, psychiatric medications work well. For other people, they don't work at all. And then for other people, they can cause pretty serious side effects. For instance, SSRIs, or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, sertraline being one of them, which Chinchilla refers to. They are intended to treat depression by basically increasing serotonin levels in the brain. And this is based on the serotonin hypothesis of depression, which states that depression is linked to low serotonin levels in the brain. So this was actually recently refuted by a study published in Nature in 2022. Let me find it. Okay. The study concluded that the main areas of serotonin research provide no consistent evidence of there being an association between serotonin and depression, and no support for the hypothesis that depression is caused by low serotonin activity or concentrations. I thought that was interesting, but it still seems that for some people, SSRIs do help alleviate depression. So perhaps there's some other mechanism of action. But anyways, SSRIs can potentially cause adverse effects. Weight gain, low libido, and digestive issues are probably three of the more common ones. I think it's really important for people to work with a physician who takes the time to talk with them about potential side effects of psychiatric medications, and also takes the time to follow up with the patient closely to monitor how they're doing. In this current healthcare system, at least in the US, where many physicians are forced into not spending much time with patients, some appointment slots are like 5 minutes. Obviously, a lot is lost when a physician cannot spend enough time with the patient. This leads to decreased trust in the system, in the physicians. But I think there's hope. I think that a lot of physicians recognize the problem, and a good amount of them are leaving the system and perhaps starting their own practices, finding ways around the broken system. So it goes, let it be. And the girl knows I'm balanced on my toes so I can breathe. But little by little, I'm pushing back down with a new habit. If not for long, just for a while, I bury myself with a great big smile. Oh mama, oh mama, we trace ourselves in these chalk outlines. Oh mama, oh mama, erase ourselves. Scared of being okay, cause all things change, all things change. It's such a perfect day, it's a beautiful shame, it's a beautiful shame. I'm scared of being okay, cause all things change. They're scared of being okay, they're scared to be happy. There's a term for this, like when you're fearful of being happy because you think that something bad is going to happen. What is that called? I mean, let's Google it. Cherophobia. Cherophobia is the aversion to or fear of happiness. Cherophobia often comes when people try to protect themselves stemming from a past conflict, tragedy, or trauma. I think to some extent, many people feel this way. The longer someone lives, the more challenges they face, and if those challenges are really traumatic and stressful, over time, this kind of conditions the brain, conditions the person to be more fearful.
It's such a perfect day, it's a beautiful shame, it's a beautiful shame. I'm scared of being okay, cause all things change. But little by little, bit by bit, I'll push it back down with a new habit. If not for long, just for a while, I'll bury myself with a great big smile. Oh mama, oh mama, we trace ourselves in these chalk outlines. Oh mama, oh mama,
let's go out. That's a great song. I love their two voices. They go so well together. Beautiful, beautiful song. One big point that they make in their lyrics is that these medications they're on induce this sort of numbness where they feel like they're an empty shell. This is the case for some people who take psychotropic medicines. I remember a person who was very close to me during medical school who started an SSRI, and I remember her telling me that she felt numb. And I think at that time in her life, that was really stressful. I think feeling numb was better than feeling the pain that she had been experiencing prior to starting the medication. But I think in the long term, she felt like she had to taper off of the SSRI. She was on an SSRI because in the long term, she felt like it wasn't allowing her to process the stressful events properly, if that makes sense. She was just too numb to process them. That brings up an important point that sometimes the underlying cause is not addressed by the medication. And so I think it's really, really important for someone who is on a psychiatric medication to work with their physician to identify the underlying root cause of the psychological or the psychiatric ailment. For instance, increased inflammation in the body, whether it's from a reaction to certain food that you're eating or whether it's from an autoimmune illness, can actually contribute to depression and other mood disorders. And so dealing with that inflammatory state and working to decrease inflammation can help alleviate the mood symptoms. Whereas if you're just started on a psychiatric medication without addressing the underlying cause, you're really just putting a band-aid on it, not really addressing the root issue. I'm not saying that all cases of depression and mood disorders are related to increased inflammation. I was just using that as an example. There are other systemic issues, other systemic disorders that can contribute to mood disorders. So it's really important for someone to work with a physician who has the time to devote that sort of energy to their patient. There's a really good book that I'm currently reading that talks a lot about that. It's called The Anatomy of Anxiety. It specifically deals with anxiety, obviously. It's written by a psychiatrist, a functional psychiatrist. Her name is Dr. Ellen Vora. Highly recommend that you read it if you're interested. She talks about the potential root causes of anxiety. She talks about how modern life, technology, food, hormones can all contribute to anxiety disorders. This is a great book for anybody who is interested in that topic. Amazing song by Ren and Chinchilla. Thank you guys for recommending it. This is NeuroGal MD, and we'll catch you next time. Bye.